What will I communicate? I will communicate my story. Listen to the basketry experts as they communicate their story.
To this day, California basketry is some of the most sought after basketry in the art world. People are really always looking for the weaving that's been done in California. They make these beautiful baskets.
The native Californians are successful with their basketry. I will communicate my successes. Say it with me. I will communicate my successes.
We hunted, we gathered. We were also mothers and fathers. We were also doctors, and we were also botanists and biologists and mathematicians, all those things you can see in our basketry. Our story has always been, what do we need to do to make sure that we are always here? And how can we make plans for always being here?
This basketry expert is communicating her plans. They want to make plans for always being here. Say it with me. I will communicate my plans.
These designs and this way that we make things really stands the test of time.
Baskets, when you look at them across time, you can almost have a conversation with the maker. You can see them making decisions, deciding on particular materials or a particular technique. Looking at a basket is being able to, in some ways, sort of talk across time and admire masters of work.
This expert says that looking at a basket helps you talk across time. You can admire masters at work. The baskets communicate the strengths of the artist. I can communicate my strengths like these artists did with their baskets. Say it with me. I will communicate my strengths.
If you ever have tried to make a basket, then you start to have a great deal more respect for how difficult it is. You know, it's a three-dimensional object, and you are having to lay out designs on that object and have them work with that shape. You just have to be able in your mind to see the finished product and then break it down into all the different steps along the way, which is actually a lot of math and geometry.
This basketry expert talks about how challenging it is to make a basket. When you look at a woven basket, you can see the curves, you can notice the math and the thinking it takes to make that basket. These artists communicated those challenges. You can also communicate your challenges. Say it with me. I will communicate my challenges.
Baskets were the primary tools of life. You could hunt with baskets, fish with baskets, you could carry things with baskets, cook with baskets, you harvested food, processed food, made beautiful things to give as gifts. And I think really one of the reasons we were able to do that here was because of that variety of plants. California is one of the spots in the whole world that has kind of the most diverse plant communities. And so you have this really cornucopia of plants that you can choose from to make your baskets. Today you'll see weavers that are not just from one tribal tradition, but from several tribal traditions that are mixing and matching, or weavers that are from one tribal tradition that are living somewhere else. And so they're using those materials with their home style of weaving methods. So much more just like the world today. It's much more diverse and multicultural. Californian basketry is moving with the time.
This basketry expert talks about how Californian basket weavers have lots of different influences. Through their basket, they can communicate their style. They pull from different places to create their own unique style. They also communicate their growth, how they have grown or changed over time. Say it with me. I will communicate my growth. I will communicate my style.
Some people don't know about basket. They say, oh, where you buy your material? I said, no, I go and collect my own materials.
This basket weaver collects her own materials. When she creates a basket, she shows us all of her different skills, including how she collects and makes her own materials. My skills. Say it with me. I will communicate my skills.
Basket is so much more than just the product. It's a year or more of tending your gathering places and singing to those plants and all the stories and songs around that particular place and that particular plant. And the stewardship that goes along with being a weaver is immense. You tend to those things that are going to give of themselves so that you can practice your art. It's really a lifelong learning. It's cultural, it's biological, it's, it's scientific. When you have to gather and process and dye your own materials, it's a much more complex artistic endeavor.
These weavers are tending the places or taking care of them that they go to get their materials. They take care of those plants. They sing to those plants. They pass stories down about those places. That's what matters to them. They will communicate what matters to them. They are also communicating what they have learned from their family, from their ancestors, from their community. They communicate what they learned. Say it with me. I will communicate what matters to me. I will communicate what I have learned. Thank you.
People like my cousin Tima, she's in the archives and she's visiting with the with those traditional baskets that are in museum collections to really learn from them. And their whole purpose is to revitalize it for the next generation. And so they're teaching. They're not only gathering all of this information and making their own art, but they're also sharing it with the community and in the most generous, beautiful way.
This basketry expert talks about her cousin, Tima. She says that her cousin wants to teach about their customs and traditions. Her cousin has a goal of what she wants to do. You will communicate your goals. My goals. Say it with me. I will communicate my goals.
When you change from thinking about basketry and weaving as strictly functional and recognize that even in the function, there's art, how far can you stretch that art? You could stretch it anywhere you want. My joy as an artist is to start combining and stretching my thoughts about my weaving. Every culture around the world changes, innovates, moves forward. And if they don't, their culture dies. Weavers here in California, we're under actually a lot of pressure not to change, not to innovate, not to move forward from the outside world. If you take one step outside of this sort of box that they've decided is traditional, then what you're doing to them isn't true basketry, isn't true tradition. What's hard for us is, as a weaver, my obligation isn't to them, it's to my community. My obligation is to make sure that whatever changes happen in our communities, that I respond to them and help our culture move forward. My favorite moment as a weaver is when I have to innovate. I have to change something. So I'll look at this object that I'm making and I'm like, how am I going to fix this problem? How am I going to change this and fix the problem? I weave for the needs of my community, but every once in a while, I weave because I want to. So you also have a need as an artist?
This basket weaver is very innovative. She communicates her innovative ideas in her art. My innovative ideas. Say it with me. I will communicate my innovative ideas. She also creates her art because it's what she wants to do to help her community. It's what inspires her. You can communicate what inspires you. What inspires me? Say it with me. I will communicate what inspires me. She also communicates solutions to problems in her baskets. My solutions to problems. Say it with me. I will communicate my solutions to problems.